Now I'd like to do something about this. I don't want to get rid of it because it's kind of neat. I don't know why water kind of does that. It sorts itself out if you put a block underneath. I need a shovel, really. Oh, we'll leave that for another day. But I just want to make it so I stop falling straight into it, just like that. And I can promise you that the pop shield is ordered, and I've been saying it for a long time. I've ordered a new pop shield for my microphone. It's on its way. You won't have to put up with listening to my horrible breathing noises for much longer. I'm just going to fill in the very bottom of this crater, and perhaps a little like this too, just to give it a bit more character. Like that, that'll do. That'll do nicely. Right. So let's go back indoors. That's pretty much everything that I need to do outdoors. Do I have glass? Yes, I do. Well, let's just refill this. See, that doesn't look terrible from the inside, and it gives me a better view. I still haven't decided on a material for my inside walls. I think cobblestone won't be that nice. You know, it's fine for the outside wall. But actually having it for the interior walls as well will be a bit too much cobblestone. Wood obviously is used for the floor. That would be my second immediate choice. Smooth stone I don't think will look right because that's a natural, and I'm using that for a kind of ultra strong features of the architecture, you know, the foundations, and so it blends in with the natural rock. Sandstone will not be in style at all. Now, you can make pictures. So, let's have a look at these. Because if they're, and I'm sorry about the mouse clicks as well, hopefully that will be a thing of the past once I manage to be able to turn my gain down. There we go, painting. So let's have a look at this. Now, from what I've heard, what I've seen, what I've read in the file, you can place it. Oh, and it causes lag. And if you don't like the one it's chosen, there we go, just left click and it will cycle through them all. That's wow. Well, while this is going to go a long way to proving the decor, I can't just, and that's back to the start now, isn't it? So how do I get it back? Hit it with something, hit it with a pick, there we go. That doesn't solve the problem of what material to use for the interior. And there I am kind of stuck. I mean, dirt obviously no. Just looks like dirt. One interesting concept is to use dyed wool, but It kind of looks, if anything, like carpet, which it's not what I want. I'll show you. This is just white wool, but it's, I think it's got the same texture. No, it's got a different texture, but it still doesn't look right for walls. The coloured walls, of which I don't have any. I don't think. Let's have a quick check. Well, I might have a grey one. Not in there, I don't. And not in there, I don't. Well, they have a different texture anyway, and... Oh, look, I have this, which is used as a dye. How do I use it as a dye? That's the question. Is it like this? There we go. So I've made a blue wool. You can see already in my hand that is not going to be good for a wool. It is a very vivid blue, though, I have to say. And blue is going to be in plentiful supply with that lapis lazuli mine. So it'd be right to do something in this house which is blue, maybe the carpets. But then I think I might have made a mistake only making the carpets or the floors and the ceilings, I should say, a single block thick. Like this here, you can see the underside of this block is the ceiling texture, the top side is the floor texture, so that's why it has to be wood, really, because that's the only common material that makes sense, or stone, but it's wood. So do you know what, I've had an idea about these corners. There goes my mind again, getting completely distracted. And there goes my tongue again, twisting just as I'm mid-sentence. Because, now, these look like, when you string fences together, so they, it puts down the post, and then it automatically, is it getting dark? Automatically links the rails in between. But if you've just got one down, it's just a post. And something I saw while I was doing my challenge map was something along the lines of this. Now, how about that? For a little detail in there, just to break up that gap. Doesn't disturb my view too much, still gives me that nice panoramic view. It should still be spider-proof, though I bet you any... Yeah, look, you can see the bounding box. I'm now touching the screen as if you can see my finger. You can see the bounding box. It's actually a full block, despite appearances. So that would leave me with the same problem. It does look good, though. Even if I do put it back to full blocks, I might do that anyway. That looked quite nice. So... I would like to get the walls done before I put the roof on. I don't know, that might be the wrong way around actually. But yeah, because I don't know how high the walls have to be until. So the next job is in fact putting the roof on. Now, there are no sloping. I just fill up with junk so quickly. Let's just get rid of it. That goes in the kitchen, these goes in the kitchen. These go in the kitchen, I should say. Under the... Oh no, I still need to do the windows, so I should be thinking about those. Let's put those away. Alright, let's get wood out, because there are no sloping kind of tiles in, blocks in Minecraft, no sort of diagonal sloping ones, but what you do have is steps made like this, And actually, I'll show you. If you look at this, these steps here, I mean, imagine that as the roof line. Okay, it's jaggedy, but it's not as jaggedy as, you know, doing like this as my roof line. So it's still, and it's still Minecrafty because it's still blocks, but they're little blocks. And actually, later on, when I've built all sorts of machines, when I built one machine in particular, the saw, I can create panels and half blocks and quarter blocks and all eighth blocks and all sorts of things. Panels, mouldings, and I forget now. I haven't got my cheat sheet in front of me. I was looking at it in bed last night and trying to work things out. So anyway, I came up with a design which is half stolen because I have seen it elsewhere. Well, I've seen something similar enough that this isn't really an original my idea, but it was heavily based off this idea that I've seen elsewhere. And of course this roof, I'm not going to be able to put torches on it, and that's the other thinking behind this design. Now, can I just, these place and direction you're facing, so if I can do this, and then just, you want that edge there. Uh-oh, creeper. Do not fall down. Good. Good, that works perfectly. Oh, well, I'm going to need to go and make a whole bunch of steps, so. But you kind of get the idea in that. I wonder if, because I'm going to need loads of steps, whether this would be a good idea. I wonder if you can. It'd be nice if you could just sort of shift click and make a maximum stack. But it seems you can't, it just automatically, seems you can't, it just automatically puts it in your inventory. Hello, little creeper. You're hiding from me. Hello. At least he's not a skeleton. A skeleton would make this actually impossible. And I've deliberately done it over the, you know what? If I covered up that corner, the spiders can't get up anyway. I've covered it with the roof. So, problem solved. I can go ahead and do exactly what I want. Oh, I've already done this wrong, though. Typical. This was going to be the side of the triangle. I think doing a sort of pyramid roof would be a bit too modern. You know, where this side slopes up and meets the gable in the middle, and then these sides slope. I think I just want this side sloping, and then this side to continue as a plane straight up. You know, a triangular shaped plane. Because I think the kind of triple, if all three sides slope in towards one point, it might look too modern. But having said that, if I destroy those now, I'll lose them, so. Oh, I'm stuck now. Well, it's wood. I'm not exactly sure what wood. Thanks, last words.